सर, माय नेम इज शुक्ला शैन. आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माय पेपर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ माय को-ऑथर डॉक्टर संयुक्त मोइत्रो. सो मे आई स्टार्ट माय प्रेजेंटेशन?
गो अहेड.
थैंक यू सर.
जस्ट 15 मिनट्स.
ओके सर.
स्टिक टू द टाइम पे.
Our topic is pandemic and the construction sector in India, assessing the impact of labor migration. So first I would like to give a brief introduction of my paper, that is the construction sectors is one of the most unorganized sector, employment sector in India, and the construction workers are one of the most vulnerable group who are also the worst affected during the pandemic. So I would like to focus on the magnificent structures that we gave at in the big cities can be credited to the toil and hardships of construction workers who remain invisible in the crowd. Every day, millions of laborers migrate to big cities to fight poverty and uncertainties relating to their future. Like other developing countries, construction workers continue to face challenges and insecurity in the cities and are often neglected by the administration. The Building and the Construction Workers Act, there are various legislations starting from the constitution, constitutional provisions to the national legislations and the international provisions, which deal with the protection of rights of the building and other construction workers. But however, this group of workers and the laws which are available to these workers, they are less implemented. And moreover, the outbreak of COVID-19 outbreak, COVID-19 pandemic followed by the lockdown has caused immense hardships to these workers across the country. The appalling sights of their suffering, begging before the administration for a safe return to their villages, reflect their adversities. Now, who are the construction workers? Construction workers are those who work predominantly on construction sites and are typically engaged in the regular aspects of the industries other than design and financing. Section 2D of the Building and Other Construction Workers Regulation of Employment and Condition of Services Act 1996 deals with the definition of building or construction work, means the construction, alteration, repairs, maintenance or demolition of in or relation to buildings, streets, roads, work, flood control works, including storm water, drainage work, generation, transmission and distribution of power, etc., but does not include any building or other construction works to which the provisions of Factories Act 1948 or the Mines Act 1952 apply. Section 2E defines building worker, which means a person who is employed to do any skilled, semi-skilled or unskilled manual, supervisory, technical or clerical work for hire or reward, whether the terms of employment be expressed or implied in connection with any building or other construction work. Now, what are the reasons for increase in international or internal migration of these workers? Like poverty, lack of decent work for women, increase in demand of female labor in destination countries or cities, remittances for country of origin, safety and stability, freedom, higher wages and job prospects, food availability, better environment, family needs, better quality of life, availability of services. Now, let's come. I would like to focus on the smart cities and the labor migration. The smart cities and the labor migration, which was launched by our Honorable Prime Minister in the year 2005, these construction workers who leave their cities with a desire to work to get a better life are the neglected and neglected group of communities in the smart cities. The migrant laborers who build the smart cities, preferring their labor to fuel the development of industries and cities in urban areas in return of meager wages, lack of social securities, are tucked away in some avoided corner of the cities. Thousands of migrant workers who toil hard and upon whose labor sacrifices losses, blood and sweats, the construction industries and development of cities rely, at the end of the day, they depart to their makeshift camps, and upon accomplishment of the project, means what happened, they are again departed to another place, likely in another city. But the heroic story of these workers means upon only the based on the construction workers who step out from their rural villages for striving hard at urban development with a desire to earn money, they do not get better better opportunities to survive. They merely get stuck into the hands of wicked contractors into the disorganized sectors, where they are overlooked and are left at the sympathy of this contractors. Like the terms sustainable, smart city, mixed land use, workable places denote a little to the thousands of migrant construction workers who hardly get any opportunity to use it. So there are various human rights which are conferred on the migrant construction workers. Like they are the human right to protection of the child from economic exploitation and from any work that may be hazardous to his or her well-being. Human right to return home if the migrant wishes. Human right to a standard living adequate for the health and well-being of migrant worker and his or her family. Human right to safe working condition and a clean and safe working environment. Reasonable limitation of working hours, rest and leisure. Freedom of association and to join a trade union. Freedom from sexual harassment in the workplace. Protection during pregnancy. Protection of the right of the child of migrant workers to education. Right to reunification with the family. Equal pay for equal work. Freedom from forced labor. Protection from arbitrary expulsion from the state of employment. There are various key international legal provisions which are focused on the migrant workers, like the UDHR 1948, ICCPPR, International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, UN Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Racial Discrimination 1990. There are various even key ILO instruments. The role of ILO plays a major role as a there are various international instruments which are focused on the rights of the migrant construction workers. Like the role of ILO is a international international agency which are mainly focused on these rights. Like the International Labour Organization, which was set up in the year 1990. Promote social justice and decent work for both men and women, irrespective of the race, sex, gender or social origin. ILO furnishes support to states with ratification or utilization of various international labor standards and furnishes technical collaboration, including sectors such as labor law firm, fundamental principles and rights at work, employment plans, labor market, information, industry, advancement, vocational training, microfinance, social safety, occupational safety and health, working conditions, labor administration, industrial relations, labor inspections. There, coming to the national legislations and to the constitutional provisions, apart from the international perspectives, according to the Constitution of India, the directive principles of state policy, Article 39, 41, and Article 39, 41 and 42 of the Indian Constitution, focuses on the rights of the, of any workers to protect their right, and even they are entitled to right of an adequate means of livelihood, equal pay for equal work for both men and women, protection against abuse and exploitation of work, economic necessity, protection of their health and strength, facilities to develop in a healthy manner, which are all laid down under Article 39, 41 and 43. The legal provisions which are applicable, the national legislations which are applicable to construction workers, like there are various labor laws which can be said that can be applied to the construction workers, but in our practical life we can see that these labor laws are less implemented for any benefits, or the construction workers hardly get any benefit from the labor laws. Like the Employees Compensation Act 1923, Trade Unions Act 1926, Payment of Wages Act 1936, Industrial Disputes Act, Minimum Wages Act, Payment of Bonus Act, Interstate Migrant Workmen Act 1979, Contract Labor Regulation and Abolition Act 1970, Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, Unorganized Workers Social Security Act 2008. The there is also a legislation, Maternity Benefits Act 1961, which applies to the women workers employed in construction industry, but the number of benefits is limited due to the intermittent nature of employment of these construction workers. In addition, there are though this legislation, labor laws legislations, these construction workers are not so much benefited from these labor laws. With a view, central legislation has been enacted to protect the interests of the construction workers, like the building and the other construction workers, Regulation of Employment and Condition of Services Act 1996, and the Building and Other Construction Workers Welfare Act 1996. There are various national policies for the migrant construction workers, like the One Nation, One Ration Card Scheme, Garib Kalyan Rozgar Abhiyan, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, Janasri Bima Yojana, Janasri Suraksha Yojana, Rashtriya Swastha Bima Yojana. There are various legislations, various benefits, through document, there are various legislations, various benefits are being conferred on these migrant workers. But the problems which the migrant workers daily face can be seen that they are, apart from getting benefits of this legislations, they are not entirely benefited and they are not not only relief from their entire problems. The problems of these migrant workers are the casual nature of work. They are very illiterate and they're ignorant of all the laws which are available to them. There are low wages for these workers. They hardly get any social security. There are no fixed working hours, unwholesome working conditions, like the working these migrant construction workers have to work even during the summer season or the rainy days. Their vulnerability of getting affected to the occupational diseases, serious accidental injuries, insufficient implementation of labor laws, like the limited there are limited definition of organized sector in the labor legislations. The Industrial Disputes Act Section 2J which deals with the definition, they are not so much benefited with the act. The Workmen's Compensation Act 1923, they hardly get any compensation facilities, insufficient labor welfare activities, no payment for holidays. The women migrant construction workers are the most vulnerable because sometimes they have to face exploitation like sexual harassment, and the expected mothers are also not they do not get any benefit from the employers or the contractors who hire them for any activities. Impact of gig, we can focus on the impact of gig economy on the economic sectors. People who are one part of the gig economy have diverse advantages, but they have only freedom to choose their working hours, leave, and preferred institutions. Moreover, there are various disadvantages which the gig economy involve, lack of stability.
You are requested to wind up in another 2 minutes.
Okay, sir. Undetermined pay schedules, unsteady workload, absence of social benefits or any statutory protection, like a worker in a permanent employment, and there is no fixed determination of any pay scale and its continuity. The importance of 73rd and the 74th constitutional amendment, which mainly focuses on the role of which states that the states are expected to bestow pertinent powers, authorities and finances upon these bodies to permit them, but due to unavailability of any facilities in the rural sectors, there are emerging issues of migration, and the loopholes perceived it is an imperative requirement to enshrine in the constitution and strength and certain strength and powers to be imparted in the Panchayati Raj institution, so that vulnerable weak sections find sufficient sustenance and means to lead their life, and urban local bodies perform efficiently as vibrant democratic body. which is clearly laid down under Article 243W of the Constitution of India under the 12th Schedule. So as there is very limited time, so I would like to focus on the conclusion and the suggestions, which I would like to prefer as my, as the suggestions are.
Thank you.